Hello everyone. Today we will start with class 6th Civics chapter 1 Diversity. This chapter is kind of fundamental chapter that lays the foundation stone for other chapters of the civics. In this chapter we come to know about the human behavior or the social behavior which we can see in our surroundings. All right? Do you understand what is diversity? Do you have any idea? All right. I will tell you, diversity means the differences which we can see across all over the country. Those differences are called diversity. For example, you are living in Gwalior, that is the part of Madhya Pradesh. So, which language you are using to converse with your family and friend? Obviously, you are speaking either in Hindi or English. Alright? Suppose you are having a friend who belongs to Ahmedabad, that is the part of Gujarat, well-known city of Gujarat, Ahmedabad. So, which language he or she will use to speak? Definitely, he will speak in Gujarati, alright? And if you will go for the vacation in Kerala, then which kind of food you will get over there to eat? Of course, you will get fish or rice in Kerala region. These all the differences are in all the country are called diversity. Now let's move to the chapter. Here it is. Chapter 1, diversity. Diversity comes in terms of region, religion, culture, language, food habits and so on. Suppose this is our map, and in terms of the language, if a person who belongs to the Gujarat, he would speak in Gujarati, and if a person who belongs to Kerala region, definitely he would speak in Malayalam or English language. And in the region of West Bengal, people used to speak in Bengali. That has a kind of diversity within the language. We can see, like, these are the diversity of the languages. See, different languages, so many languages. Almost 800 language we are having in our country, those people are speaking. So these are the few language of them: English, Hindi, Odia, Bengali, Malayalam, Urdu, Kannad, Sanskrit, Punjabi, Bhojpuri, Tamil, etc. All right, now we are going to understand region deeply. What is the region? Now you can mark the region on the basis of geographical features or economical condition of the and the social condition of the country. Like here, this is the Deccan Plateau, this is the part of desert region, and here at the southernmost part we have the coastal region. Alright, now let's move to the religion. India is predominantly a Hindu nation, but still we have many religions like Jainism, Buddhism, Muslims, Persians and so on. These are the various religions which we are having in our country that is prevalent across all over India. Alright. Now, what kind of differences we can see across the country? We can see the differences in terms of language, in terms of clothes, in terms of festivals, in terms of looks, in terms of foods, etc. All these differences are the fundamental cause or the basis of diversity that occurs in India. Okay, food in the coastal area are fish and rice. It is the staple food of the coastal region, because this region is just about that ocean or seas area. And the food in the northern plains, that is the wheat. Wheat is the staple food of northern region. Now let's move forward to the generations. It is very important to understand the generation. What is the generation? It means if a father is doing a business like poultry, a son would inherit that and would learn only that skill. and that was considered sufficient for him. But now with the changing time and trends, it is changing. Now in the changing India, people choose different kind of profession in spite of the profession of their parents or the grandparents. Now let's move forward to the caste system. What is the caste system? Caste system is the main cause of inequality in our country. It means we are having different caste like Hindu, Muslim, Sikh, Christians, and many more caste we are having in our society. That would be a great cause of inequality. To remove out these inequalities, there were various leaders like Bhim Rao Ambedkar who worked forward and they tried to bring the society at par. Now there are many kinds of reservation for the scheduled caste, scheduled tribe, minorities that we would see later on. Now let's move to the concept of the cultural assimilation. Is it there in India? Yes or no? It is very important to understand whether the cultural assimilation is there in India or not. Cultural assimilation means integration of the various things culturally or economically. It has to be given great importance and has to be focused on. So let's see, let's say generations back, our grandparents and great grandparents might be using road as the means of transport, but the road could be a kind of unpaved road with bullock carts, wheels, etc. Slowly and gradually, our generation has witnessed buses, trains, and aeroplanes, and so on and so forth. So there has been changes in the means of transport that has been requirement of the time, changing time. Again, people have been moving from one place to another for the various reasons, like people moved for the job, people moved for the education, people moved for the medical facilities, people moved due to drought, due to earthquake or any other natural disaster that has been occurred in the country. People also moved because of trade. So all these movement of the people is led to kind of intermingling of the people. So let's say a person of Rajasthan moving to West Bengal, he is taking his culture or religion with him from Rajasthan to the West Bengal. So that is called the cultural assimilation of different areas. Alright, in this chapter there has been a great coverage of two extreme regions. One is Ladakh and the other one is Kerala. Ladakh is the northernmost part of the country and Kerala, it is the southernmost part of our country, India. Now first we are going to understand Ladakh. Okay, Ladakh is a cold desert, as you all know that is very cold desert, and we get the water from the melting snow in the Ladakh region. Sheep are very commonly can seen in the Ladakh region, and that's why people used to make the pashmina wool. Most of the people are engaged to making carpets and wool making work they are doing, and the cattle that we can easily see over this region are goats, cows, and dizos, that is called yak cows. Alright, Ladakh is known as the trade route for caravan from China and Tibet region. Through this region, people doing the work of textile and spices and silk and other trades. In this region, main influence of the religion Buddhism and Islam because of the impact of China on the Ladakh region. So we can see the Buddhism and Islam region mostly in this part of the country. Ladakh region is very rich in the songs and poetry. People of this region are very well qualified to do such kind of activities like songs and poetry. They are very well in this. Let's move forward. Kerala. Kerala, as you can see over here, it is the southernmost part of the country. So obviously it is very hot by temperature, southernmost hai. So Kerala is surrounded by the sea, so it has a kind of backwater in the coastal area. It is highly influenced by the Arab travelers. Jews and Arabs came first in the Kerala region. Again, you have Vasco da Gama from Portugal came here in Kerala, in contrast to the Chinese who came in the Ladakh region. All right, we can find the history about Ibn Battuta, who has wrote a lot of books about the life of the Muslim in this region, Kerala region. Now the vegetation that has seen here is mainly the species like pepper, cardamom and cloves. These are the main species which we can see over here in this region. Here you can see the fishing nets which are used to catch the fishes, and that are called chinawala. This word is just similar like Chinese word chinawala. All right, it is used to catch the fishes. Because Kerala is the coastal region, so fishing is the very important work which people are doing in this region. Agriculture is not there, okay? People are engaged in the fishing activities, and the utensils which they are using to fry the fish, that is called china chatti. All right, and people eat mainly rice and fish in this region. That is the predominant food of this region, Kerala region. Now let's move to the unity in diversity. That is the soul of our chapter, unity in diversity. The term unity in diversity has first given by the Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru. Let's move toward it. So despite of so much differences that we have seen in the form of language, culture, religion, reason and so on, there is a kind of unity across the nation. Now that unity comes in the form has been witnessed in the form of various episodes of the independence movement that we would see in the further chapters of the civics. All right, now Britishers have tried to work around the divide and rule policy in India that ultimately failed. And we were united against the common fight of independence movement with the Britishers. So you had the Jallianwala Bagh massacre that happens when General Dyer had opened the firing, and the people laid down their lives in the well at the Jallianwala Bagh itself. It was a kind of complete unity which we could see at that time, when there was no Muslim, no Hindu, no Sikh, no Christian, no rich, no poor, not at all. They all the people of India, and they all laid down their lives for their country India. We have different kind of songs, symbols and national anthem which has been written by Rabindranath Tagore that bind our nation much closer. We Indians has to give respect to our national anthem and all the national symbol. That is our fundamental duty. All right, in the further chapter we know about the fundamental right and the fundamental duties. Let's discuss further on. So the term unity in diversity was first given by Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru. He was trying to explain his feelings in the book, in his book Discovery of India, which he has written about the Indian culture and the Indian condition of that time. He explained the term unity in a very deeply manner. He explained that how we people are united in spite of having a lot of differences among them. We have united in all the conditions. Collectively, we called Indians in spite of having the different languages, cultures, religion, region, caste system and all. We all are called Indians. Jawaharlal Nehru used to say that unity is something that does not come from outside. It is something that has to be witnessed by us from itself, from within. Alright? So, it was the chapter Civics, chapter 1, Diversity of the Civics, class 6. Hope you will understand it very well. Thank you. So, it was our chapter, the diversity. Now, let's move forward towards the exercise. See, here it is exercise of our chapter. So, the first question is, choose the correct answer and fill in the blanks. Alright? And the first question is, India has about dash languages. So, how many languages are there in India? It is about 800 languages are there in India. You can see here in the chapter also. Here, linguistic diversity. Linguistic means language. Alright? India has a diverse list of spoken languages. At least 800 languages and 2000 dialects have been identified, of which 22 languages have been recognized by the Constitution of India. How many languages has been recognized by the Constitution of India? 22 languages, alright. Now, let's move on the second question. Second question is, Kerala is known for its with the West spice trade, silk trade, both A and B, none. So, what would be the correct answer, you know? Okay, I will tell you the correct answer. Correct answer is spice trade. Kerala is mainly famous for the spices, alright. There are various kind of spices has been produced in Kerala, like cardamom, cloves, black pepper and all. These are the spices which has been produced in Kerala region. Now, the next question is, the phrase unity in diversity was coined by. So, ye jo phrase tha, unity and diversity, first who has given this phrase? Vincent Smith, Jawaharlal Nehru, Mahatma Gandhi or Indira Gandhi. So, what would be the correct answer? Yes, he is Jawaharlal Nehru and he has given the phrase unity in diversity very first time. So, the correct answer would be Jawaharlal Nehru. Now, the next one, Ladakh is famous for its. Ladakh, why the Ladakh is famous? Pashmina wool, spices, textile, local attire. So, as you all know that spices, Kerala is famous for the spices. Alright. So, Ladakh region is famous for its Pashmina wool. It is very expensive wool. You can see over here in your chapter. Here you can see the famous Pashmina wool, better known as Kashmir wool, comes from the eastern Ladakh and the western Tibet. Thole to Srinagar from Western Tibet, Thole to Srinagar were skilled artisan weave it into shawls. So, why we have used Pashmina wools? Pashmina wools has been used for making the shawls and the sweaters and all. And this is a very expensive kind of wool. And it fetches good money in the international market also. We can export it to the foreign countries. Alright. So, Pashmina wool is the correct answer of this. Now, let's move forward. Fill in the blanks. There are about 800 languages in India, of which dash are recognized by the Indian Constitution. Right now, I have told you that how many languages are there in India. You can see over here in the first, choose the correct answer. India has 800 languages over there. Alright, and out of these, 22 languages has been recognized as the Indian Constitution. That those 22 languages are called the national languages. Okay, Next one, the people of Ladakh wear dash clothes throughout the year. So as you all know that where is Ladakh? Ladakh is the northernmost part of the country and it is very cold. Okay, Ladakh, another name of Ladakh is the cold desert. Ladakh ko kya bola jata hai? Cold desert bhi bola jata hai. Although desert are not cold, desert ka naam sunte hi aapke mind mein kya picture click karti hai? A picture of Rajasthan and the desert area that are usually very hot. But the Ladakh is the cold desert because it has been there in the northernmost part of the country, India. Alright. So if it is the northernmost part of the country and if it is very cold, then which kind of clothes people would wear over there? So the people wear warm clothes throughout the year. Which clothes? WARM. People wear warm clothes throughout the year because it is very cold throughout the year. The next one. Very little dash is possible in Ladakh due to the scarcity of water. As you all know that Ladakh has the very scarcity of water. Water is no more over there in a sufficient quantity for the agricultural production. So very little agriculture is possible in Ladakh due to the scarcity of water. Is it possible to grow the crops without the water? No, na. So that's why without the water it is very difficult to produce anything on the land area. Next one, Kerala is also referred to as, Kerala is also known as God's own land. God's own land. Okay, why it is called God's own land? You can see over here, Kerala. See, Kerala, which goes with the slogan God's own land for promoting tourism, is one of the smallest state in the Indian Union. This phrase is used for promote tourism in this region. All right. See, this is the beach, Marari Beach in Kerala. You can see here. Alright. Let's move forward to the match the columns. Here you can see. First one, Kerala. Which could be the correct answer of it, you can think. Fishing net? No. Coconut? Yes, it would be the correct answer. Coconut would be the correct answer of Kerala region. Because coconut is the main production of this Kerala region, alright. Persians. Persian. What would be the correct answer of Persians? So correct answer will be Zoroastrianism. This would be the correct answer of Persian. Alright. Now the next one is Ladakh. As I have already told you, Ladakh is the very northernmost part of the country and it is just nearby to the China and Tibet region. So this is also called Little Tibet. Alright, so it would be the correct answer of Ladakh. Chinawala. Chinawala is a kind of fishing net which the people used in Kerala for catching the fishes. So it would be the fourth answer. Chinawala means fishing nets. And while I was explaining the chapter, I told you that one utensil which the people used in Kerala for frying the fish. Could you tell me the name of that utensil which the Kerala's people used for frying the fishes? Okay, I will tell you. That is called China Chatti. Alright, that is the utensil which the Keralian people use to fry the fishes. Alright, and China Wala is the fishing net. So, it was our exercise. You have to learn it very well, Bitta. And the next one, answer the following question. What is diversity? We can say that what is diversity? Diversity means the differences. I will tell you the answer. You can write it over here in your notebook or you can understand it here only. Diversity means the differences which are prevailed across all over the country. Alright. What is meant by linguistic diversity? Linguistic diversity, I have already told you that what is the linguistic diversity? Linguistic diversity means the differences which are prevailed among the people in terms of languages. See, how many languages are there in India? It is almost 800 languages. All right. So these languages are the main source of linguistic diversity. We can say that India has very rich linguistic diversity, as we have a lot of languages here. So the next one, now I would like to give you the homework. You have to do some homework with by your own self. See, this is your homework. Find out the 22 languages recognized by the Constitution of India. See, now you all know that India has a rich linguistic diversity, as India is having almost 800 languages all over the country. People are speaking up. So these languages shows the great diversity in the term of languages. Out of these 800 languages, our constitution has picked up 22 languages as the national languages. So what is the homework of yours? Your homework is, you have to find out these 22 languages recognized by the Constitution of India. And these 22 languages which are recognized by the Constitution of India, these languages are also known as the national languages. Okay. Now the next homework is, find the name of book by Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru in which he mentioned about the unity in diversity. First, I would like to tell you, Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru was the first Prime Minister of the independent India. He became the Prime Minister in the year 1947 after the independence. Okay. And when he was in imprisonment of the Britishers in the year between 1942 to 1946, I think. So during that time, he has written one book in which he mentioned about the unity in diversity. So you have to find out the name of the book, and you have to find out some basic details about the book which has been written by Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru. Okay. And the next homework is, find out the another name of Ladakh. When I was explaining the exercise, I told you both the languages of Ladakh. So it is your homework. You have to find out both the languages of Ladakh. And now the basic homework of yours about this chapter is this: write an essay on cultural heritage of India. So first, I would like to tell you, what is the cultural heritage? As you all know that India is having a lot of differences across all over the country among the people. So these all the differences are known as the cultural heritage. Okay, heritage means होता है धरोहर, जिसे हमें संभाल कर रखना होता है. All right, हमारी जो धरोहर होती है, जो हमारे ancestor थे, हमारे जो पूर्वज थे, उनसे हमें मिलती है, that is called the cultural heritage. So this heritage is also known as the cultural heritage. Now you have to find out the different form in which we can say that this is the cultural heritage in terms of languages, in terms of historical monuments, in terms of religions, in terms of caste and all. These all are the cultural heritage, and some are the basic things which has been picked up by the government as the cultural heritage of India. All right. So it was your homework. Get it done by yourself. Hope you will understand the chapter very well and get it, learn the exercise. All right. God bless you. Thank you.